Okay, hello everyone, welcome back to Armored Core Project Phantasma. I am SIMSteven, also known as Master Fenrel, and today we are doing the final battle. beforehand though, I'm gonna go back to the garage. I re-equipped my usual arms, plus I decided to go with the Gatling gun once again, since this is kind of my tried and true setup for missions. I may go off into the negatives because I did not see a cash reward for this mission, and I have like no money because I did some shopping between episodes as well. So we're gonna have to rectify that after the battle is over. but since we're off to the final battle, which I probably could have looked at this before when I was making the last episode and just took a look at the next mission that was coming up, but I didn't. We went off straight to the arena after that last fight with Stinger, and, well, we're pretty much all done. And, ooh, our requester is not Sumika for once. It's actually Phantasma. This is not a request. I have become Phantasma. I will destroy everything. You have been a nuisance. Oh, I think that's Stinger already. but I will invite you to the party. Come to the building known as Abyss. Alright, so apparently he's going to destroy the world if we don't come, I guess. I don't know. He wants his revenge, and we're going to put an end to this guy once and for all. So, I think we know who we're going to be fighting. I think we know kind of where everything is going at this point. I just wonder where Sumika is in all this. So, let's just get it on. And, well, let's get on with the nightmare.
Welcome to the Abyss. This is where I merged and became one with Phantasma. No one can stop me now. Die!
We did it. We destroyed Phantasma. Maybe we could have adapted the technology, but I guess it's better this way. I would like to ask for your help again later. You are quite a strong ally to have. Just Give me a discount next time, huh?
Okay, that was a bit anticlimactic. I was expecting a much longer mission, as final missions in Armored Core games usually are. However, we get to save the game and enjoy the ending, I suppose. I'm guessing there's some ending credits, so I'll be quiet here. I guess that was the end of the game. that was kind of a letdown ending, if you ask me, because it's always like, I am dying, and that was like one text box. And then Samika was like, hey, you're a strong ally, give me a discount next time, and all that. Eh. well, if you ask me though, this game was a bit more of an experiment to just kind of, you know, take what they had in the first game and, you know, make it, well, a fuller game, even though it seems more like a half game to me. But, even though the ending was a bit more disappointing than I was expecting it to be, I kind of forgot how the ending was in this game until I saw it again just now. But, yeah, that was kind of a short ending. Most missions, like I was saying before, are typically very long when you do the final mission, because there's usually a whole level you have to go through, kind of like in the first game, actually, and then you do go through the whole level, and then you probably have a loading screen, and then you have the final boss. So not only is it, you know, against a very tough opponent, which Phantasma was a pretty tough opponent, I beat him in 2 tries, you probably won't see the first attempt, but yeah, I died once, and then after I saw what he can do, I pretty much learned to stay back, because that's how he killed me the first time, is he kind of moved in, and I think he shot me with vertical, I guess, mortar grenade launchers or something like that, and it's like grenade launchers that shoot up in the air and then come back down on your head kind of deal. So Either way, that was kind of a flashy light show. It was a satisfying battle with Phantasma, although it was, you know, pretty basic either way. But it was kind of flashy and cool looking, so gotta get points for points are due. But yeah, we got some missions still up to do because there were some split paths. Got one here, one there, and one there. So we got three other missions that we need to clean up eventually. I think I'll make another extra episode for these three missions, or maybe two episodes. For now, though, we've beaten the final mission, but we're still way behind in the arena. So, we're going to make progress here today and try to get, hopefully, up to around rank 10. We'll see how far we can get in about 45 minutes of recording time, since, you know, I usually stick to around an hour. That's kind of how I do things. Off screen, I did buy more of these kinds of arms. I bought another laser gun, and one of the two cannon arms. So this is the first cannon arm, and what's the other one? The laser cannon? I think it was this one. I think I just bought this off screen, or was it? No, it wasn't this one. This is the one I used before. So we're gonna use this laser cannon in the next battle, and we'll also switch out back to our grenade launcher, our tried and true favorite combo in the back, as we experiment with these dual arm cannons. and then we'll probably just see how they do in the top 20 battles of the arena. Yeah, and then we'll kind of mess around and try and just beat the arena once we've gone through a bunch of different weaponry. Just kind of testing things out as we climb the ranks, because it doesn't really matter if we lose in this game, so I'm using that to my advantage. There is no arena record in this game, unlike later games. But yeah, let's get going on this guy, who I remember just seeing his name was Burn to the ground. And, pilot of an ominous looking AC. He has a well balanced machine and is at his command. That color palette makes me think of Joker from Batman. Just saying. Doesn't seem anything like flames, though. Green, purple, and white? I would think there'd be some red in there somewhere, but, let's not pick the wooded area against the guy named Flamer. let's pick. Probably not an industrial park either. Let's pick the Iceland against the guy named Flamer. It'll be a bit harder to see, you know, white on white. Then again, we did that last time and I got it through in like one or two tries. So let's go. That was cheap. You see that? I actually am doing what I was saying last time where I took a shot from long range where I didn't even have my lock on. Look at how much damage I did right at the start. I did like over 3/4 of his health. Even though this is like my fourth attempt trying to fight this guy, I just tried to do that, just went all out with just shooting right off the bat. And since, you know, he is straight ahead of you whenever you start this a battle on this map. So I went the cheap route and just kind of destroy them in one, you know, one bombardment of those laser cannons. But yeah, he does have some really strong weaponry, which is why, you know, it took me 4 tries to beat him. But that was a really amusing, to say the least, just to go blam, 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 and then just like, that was the end of that fight. So that's like double the arm cannons, or double the laser cannons that I love so much on my back weapon, but that was pretty awesome that I was able to do it that way. But we earned some money and all that stuff. So I'll probably buy the other arm cannons pretty soon. I did buy one of the other arm cannons, so just to make sure I know which is which, I'm going to equip this one and buy the other one after the end of this next match. And then we can say goodbye to all these weird double arming cannons that I don't typically like to use. But we're just giving them all a test run before we end this game. So anywho, we're going to get back to the arena. And, well, see who's next. Alright, his name is Sadistic. And he's got a four-legged scorpion. Is his AC name. Odd. Either way, low man on the scorpion team. His ability, he's more than average within the arena. Alright, so apparently there's multiple guys in the scorpion team, whatever it is. So, let's give him a shot. You know what, I haven't used this map too much. I don't remember liking it that much, I'll be honest to say. So, we'll see how things go. Probably even worse than before. We'll be right back. right. Nice long fight. And the first try, we actually won for once. Been a while since we won in one try. I gotta say that. Much at least. But at least this was a pretty even matchup for once. Not I die in a matter of seconds or he dies in a matter of seconds. It was actually fairly balanced. Yeah, I don't know if I really care for these arm cannons, especially not after that awesome showing with the laser cannon arms. That was kind of cheap move that I did, though, but it was pretty awesome that I pulled it off as I did. Ooh, I think this guy's got the moonlight. Yeah, good thing I didn't get hit by that, otherwise I would have been in big trouble. And he's got human plus mode, of course, if he's got the blade beams. I think that plasma can he has is also one that you can't use unless you got human plus mode. So yeah, that's kind of an interesting fight. But we're not gonna watch the whole thing. Let's just exit out and well, let's go and buy that last double arm cannon that I haven't yet bought because well, I haven't had enough money to buy it. But let's go get it. And it was another kind of cannon. Ooh, what did I just get there? We're gonna see what... We're gonna look for that in just a second. As soon as we buy these arm cannons. Should be the last thing on the list. Because see, we got a normal arm unit. And this cannon. And I think this is the arm cannon that... That one dude gave me trouble with in that... That low ceiling arena. The very first guy that gave me a lot of trouble. I think this is what he used. If not, it's the one I got equipped. So, either or. It's the other cannon, the one I don't have equipped. Where is it? It's kind of out of order because it was they were both together on the menu when I bought these between missions. Alright, so it's these. So we'll see how these things work. I think if I remember looking from when I was looking at the stats on those, I think they fire faster, but I think they do less damage overall. Now I'm not sure what was that bat that it looked like it was two parts or something. So we'll see if we can find whatever it was we just got from that match. Was it one of these things? I don't think it was that. No, I don't think it was any of those. Was it another arm part? It looked like it was two of something. There's my normal arms that I usually use. I don't think it was the machine gun or the Gatling gun. Probably a cannon of some sort, or I don't know what it was. No, I just use those laser cannons, plasma cannon. Was it this thing? I don't remember having these dual cannons. We'll probably give that a shot in the next battle, too. So, we'll see how that works as well. I don't think we have that before. So, that might have been the thing we just got. So, let's go back to the arena and fight Gepard! Panzer and IV. Obviously, sounds like it's going to be some German kind of guy. member of the AC Tech Research Center. He uses AC weapon, or he uses AAC, should maybe an AC with a multitude of weapons. Either way, let's pick another map. Let's just do a straight up arena. He's got tank legs, so he should be easy to hit no matter where he is. Because tank legs are slow as hell, so let's just get going. Oh man, that was kind of gratifying to actually pull that off. Okay, I wanted to use this battle as a bit of an example. This guy was giving me trouble, and guys like this probably could give you trouble too. Because the thing is, this dude's got double rocket launchers. Or grenade launchers, I should say. And that's kind of a cheap setup, especially if you got a super tanky, you know, a very defensive, you know, tank leg kind of AC like this guy does. So this guy is basically a one-trick pony. He wants to get you at super long range and then just fire away at you. And just kind of get you at long range and then just kind of try and, you know, take you down from long range. Which, what I decided to do here in order to beat this guy is show another technique you can use, in that you can actually run the AI out of ammo. And that is exactly what I did. So what I intended to do here is stay way the hell away and just kind of dodge his shots for as long as possible until no more came after me. And that's exactly what I did here. And you can see I also used the walls to my advantage. I think what I do is whenever I set down like that, let's go back to my view. Yeah, I would just kind of hang out behind the walls and let my energy recharge, because I knew he was slow. He's got tank legs, and he's a very slow AC by comparison. So, I basically just kind of stayed way the hell away, and just kind of, you know, I would look for shots and kind of move around in circles, because he was entirely, you know, all of his weapons are straight shots like mine are currently. So, basically, I just made sure to, you know, kind of move in circles so his shots wouldn't, you know, follow me and hit me. And then from then on, I pretty much just kind of stayed away until no shots came after me. And we just kind of did a bit of a dogfight here, which was kind of cool. You don't get those too often. But if I kind of played it out that way. But that was kind of fun, though. Beat this guy this way, because he is a bit of a difficult fighter, because, you know, two grenade launchers, you know how much stock I put into those. Grenade launchers are an incredibly powerful weapon, which is why I pretty much use one every single time in the arena here. So yeah, that's kind of why I was there, and I was way out of his range there. He could have shot at me there and probably done quite a bit of damage, because I remember I was low on energy then. But the ending here was so gratifying, because I managed to pull it off and run him out of ammo. And then when he switched to his grenade launcher, I knew by this point he was pretty low on ammo, because I know he had been shooting all of his weapons at me by that time. By the time he got to, you know, this grenade launcher, I pretty much guessed that at least one of them was out of ammo, and maybe his cannons were out of ammo. And I kind of tested the water at this point in time. See, I was still back there charging my energy there. And well, at this point, I didn't know he was out of ammo, but then I kind of went up in the air one more time, just kind of test things out. I didn't know where he was, but I kind of went around and looked for him. And fortunately, I could not find him. He apparently got stuck behind the wall. Okay, well, then he got unstuck here, and then I spotted him, and eventually I realized he's not shooting anymore. So he must be out of ammo. And then I started point blanking him with my grenade launcher. So gratifying. And so awesome for that finish. But this seems kind of like a cheap tactic that I use, but it's actually not, in my opinion. The reason for this is because, well, you gotta first survive long enough to make this happen, which, speaking of which, I've been at this guy for about the past half an hour. And I'll spare you all the attempts I've tried to beat this guy, especially the ones in the previous arena, because, well, there is no cover fire in that other arena that I was going to use, so that made this a lot harder. But there are cheaper strategies than this. Here I go with the point-blank grenade launchers. But yeah, there are cheaper strategies to use than running the enemy out of ammo. For one, missiles ahoy, missiles can be really broken if you know how to use them right. So, yeah, that is a much cheaper strategy. This is one actually requires you to be able to dodge long enough and survive long enough to have them run out of ammo. So, yeah, that's why I don't really consider it to be a cheap strategy. It's just one that you can use in case you're having trouble with a particular enemy like that guy. Anywho, like I said, I've spent about a good half an hour on that fight. And, well, we're probably not going to have as long of a time beating each of these guys up ahead. I'm probably going to go with a much cheaper setup, like I said before. I might start using, like, multi-missiles and all that. Remember back when I first started way down at the bottom here, and I used those double-back missile launchers? I might eventually go back to those later with the Kurosawa in the moonlight. And that'll probably be, like, what I'll use for the last 10 enemies up here. We're probably going to test out the those new dual cannons in the next fight. The ones we just got in the previous fight. And then we'll probably, you know, we'll clean up a couple missions in the next, one or two of the missions in the next episode, and continue on with the arena. Then maybe we'll save, like, one mission for the last episode. I don't know. I'm thinking we're going to have two episodes, but you never know. These arena mission battles are really starting to take a good long time to beat, so we might have to stretch this out to three more episodes. I don't know. Tell you what. My decision is we'll do one mission and try and beat as many arena opponents as we can in the next episode. Because we're going to need at least two episodes. So that's what we'll do. Anywho, we're going to switch back to my old arms. Then we're going to save the game and do one more mission next time around. And then do more arena matches, I suppose. And then we'll call it good. That'll probably be the next episode and all that. Yada, yada, yada. Now, I don't think I got any money. I don't think I even lost money in that battle against Phantasma. And there's one or two more things I want to say about that fight. Yeah, it was kind of flashy and all that. Pretty cool and all that. Even though it was kind of a disappointing ending. Still think it was a pretty good fight overall. It's just that I pretty much pulled out my Mega Man Legends strategies on that fight. And circle and strafed, and that was pretty much all I needed to win that fight. I really liked that move where he just used laser beams all over the place and kind of did a big rave show there. But, cool move and all that, but, well, if you circle and strafe like I did, you're probably going to survive it. Aside from that, that's about all my final thoughts I have about the final mission. The story in this game has overall been better. It was just kind of a stepping stone, in my opinion, for later games. The story never really gets all that elaborate, to be honest. At least not in the Armored Core games I played. And I played all the way up to Armored Core 3. But at least it's a good step in the right direction, like I said. Yeah, we're going to end things off here. Call it an episode, and I'll say thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time and next week.